H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
I will tell you what kind of testing you will be doing. See, when I say that mobile application, what kind of testing we will do? Let's discuss about that. What kind of testing we will do, and then at what point we will do the testing, everything we will discuss today. Now, this is one of the hybrid application structure. If you see this, When I say that mobile application, which is similar to your regular web application only. However, there is a slight difference. What is the difference we will be learning going forward? Now, if you see this, this is one of the hybrid application architecture. As a tester, we don't worry about that architecture, but at least you should know that what kind of testing we will do at each and every level. That is important. See, as a tester, I don't care about that, what is the architecture and then what is the technology they are using. But you should be knowing that what kind of testing you will be doing on each and every level. Now, if you see this, this is what is the architecture for one of the hybrid application in real time people are using. So if you see this one, this architecture is having three layers. One is backend, another one is your middle tier or middleware, and the final one is your device front end. That means this particular application is having three layers: backend, middleware, and your device front end. Now, if you see this, what kind of testing we will do from the testing point of view? When I say that backend is nothing but database, right? So whether it's a web application, whether it is a mobile application, we should have the database. Agree with me? So here also in this mobile application also, you are having your backend where all your data will be maintained, where your data will be maintained, like your enterprise data, your application data. When I say that enterprise data is nothing but your legacy data, meaning if you are developing your H2K Infosys app, so H2K Infosys app will be having so much of legacy data, how many courses are available, how many trainers are available, how many videos are available, all this data comes under your enterprise data. Enterprise data is nothing but existing data for that app. And then application data is nothing but whatever the data entered by the user. Now say for example, if you want to contact the customer care, then you will be entering some data, click on submit. So whatever the data entering by the user, that will be stored under your application data. This is the technical terms, right? So no need to worry about that. So here only point is, for any mobile application, there should be a database that is nothing but your backend. As a tester, you have to check that whether the data is correctly going to your database or not. That is nothing but your database testing, DB testing. So here we will do the DB testing. Then you are having your middleware, or you can also say that middle tier. In this middle tier, what developers will do is they will be maintaining that web services. What is web services? I will discuss in detail, because web services is very important for me, and web services also you will get a lot of opportunities. I will take one or two sessions to explain this web services. Okay, yes, Soma, right? When I say that enterprise data is nothing but the existing data of your application, and then application data is nothing but the data entered by the user. Now say for example, if you want to contact that H2K Infosys team, then what you will do as a user, you will enter all the information and click on submit. Then the form will be submitted. So when your form is submitted, what do you mean by that? Backend, whatever the data you enter, it will store into your database. That is nothing but your application data. From the testing point of view, the enterprise data, application data, whatever the data, for me same. For me, the point is, whatever the data is there in your application, that should be available in the database. That is my job as a tester. Okay. And then middle tier is nothing but it's a middleware. And middleware is nothing but here your developers, they will maintain the common functionalities. They wanted to use these functionalities across the platform. So obviously what they will do is they will maintain all these functionalities in the middle tier, or you can also say that web services. And web service, what is web services, how to use the web services, how to test the web services, we will discuss in detail. We will be having at least one or two sessions on this web services. For the time being, when the mobile application is developed, it developed based on three layers for any hybrid technology. One is your backend database, then your middle tier where your all the common functionalities will be stored. As part of your web services, you will do lot of web service testing. You will do lot of web service testing. What is web service testing? How to do that web service testing? We will discuss that in detail. And then finally, our mobile app testing will comes into picture. That is your device front end. Now, if you see this, this is your device front end. That means once I'm done with all the application development, now the application will come to your device front end. That means it can be installable in your mobile device. As part of this mobile app testing, you will do a lot of testings, installation testing, functionality testing. This is what we are going to do for any mobile app. Installation testing, functionality testing, compatibility testing, UI testing, that is user interface testing, interruption testing, network testing. So you will be having so many testings for your mobile app. What is this different testing different testing types, how to perform each and every testing, we will be discussing going forward. Here the point is, when you are testing any mobile app, majorly you will be doing DB testing. See, here I am repeating again, when you are testing any mobile app, as a tester, your responsibility is to perform your DB testing. Always DB testing is important for any app. DB testing, then followed by web services. If you are using any web services, make sure that all the web services are working fine. And then you will be the lot of device front end testings, like installation testing, functionality testing, compatibility testing, UI testing, interruption testing, and network testing. This is your mobile app testing. When I say that mobile app testing, these are all the testings you will be performing on your application. If you understand all this, then you are done with your mobile app testing. Okay, fine. Now, this is my different testing types which can be performed on any mobile application. Once this is done, now what we will do is, we will take one application and we will use this application for throughout our course. That means based on this application only, we will write the test cases. Based on this application only, we will execute the test cases. So everything we will be doing based on this particular application only. Now, this is the application. So my project manager or business analyst, he gave that requirement document saying that this is your application and this is the requirements of the application. Now what I'm doing is I'm showing you that application, how the application looks like once it is developed, and also I will give you the requirements of that particular application. That means requirements means, like, for this particular application, what we are going to develop. So what we will do is we will be writing the test cases based on this requirement document and this screenshots, or you can say that wireframes, screenshots, mockups. So different people will call differently. So this two are important for any tester. See, if you're doing any kind of testing, for me the basic documentation is requirement documents and your UI document or mock-up documents. Based on this only, we will start working with that application. Now, here, my project manager or lead, they provided this particular document saying that this is the application, this is how your application looks like after the implementation. So let's go through that quickly. This is your home page. This is your home page. And then, so in this home page, once you click on your online IT training, then user will go to this contact form and user can enter all information and you can contact to the customer care team. And then if you click on this courses, then it will show you all the available courses with H2K Infosys team. And then if you click on this videos, then all your videos will display. So this is what your application. So you are having this application and then they also highlighted that different screens, how they looks like once the application is developed. Okay. Fine. Now this is your requirements. This is your requirements. Requirements is nothing but what we are going to implement on the application. Now when you are writing the test cases, when you are testing that application, for me the primary document is requirement document. If you are having your requirement document, then only you can start writing your test cases or you can start testing your application. Without requirements, how I will write it? Requirement document is a mandatory for any tester. Okay. Now here, this is my requirement document. In this requirement document, first requirement, BR is nothing but business requirement. First requirement, BR 1.0, business requirement 1.0. Here, verify whether your mobile app supports Android and iOS platform. Here also, they clearly mentioned that Android will support Android to version 2.0 and above. And iOS will support version 4.0 and above. This is the first requirement. First requirement says that your mobile application is supporting Android and iOS platform. And Android is supporting the versions 2.0 and above. I will tell you what are all the versions available in your Android. And also I will tell you what are all the versions available in iOS. So going forward. Okay. Now here, once you see this requirement, right? So this requirement also, what you can ask some questions saying that you are saying that Android 2.0 and above. But if you simply say that 2.0 and above, I cannot test with each and every version because you are having so many versions, 2.0, 2.1, 2.3, 3.0, 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, 5.0, 6.0, so many versions are there. It is not possible to test with each and every version with the given timelines. Then what you can do is you can ask your project manager or lead about that versions, which versions we need to test, how many versions we need to test. Going forward, I will tell you what are all the different versions are available and also I will tell you how to identify the different versions for your testing. But here, please focus on that application, what we are going to use in our entire course. Then iOS is nothing but, as I said earlier, it's iPhone operating system. So iOS, what we are doing is we are testing that application for 4.0 and above. Okay, that means 4.0, 5.0, 6.0, 7.0, 8.0, 9.0, 9.2. These are all the different versions. Okay. Then, one second, then you are having that next requirement is business requirement 2.0 is successful inquiry creation. That means here, if you go back to your screens, once you click on this, you are getting your inquiry form and verify whether user is able to submit this inquiry form successfully or not. See, whether you are testing your mobile application, whether you are testing your web application, functionality will be same as usual. You have to test. Functionality is nothing but verify the functions of your application. Like this is one functionality, verify user is able to submit this inquiry form and all. Functionality testing will be as usual, whether it's a web application, mobile application, functionality will be same. You have to test your functionality as usual. So this is one requirement. Second requirement is BR 3.0 training courses module. That means verify what are all the courses are available, how many courses are available, is all the courses are accessible. That is your next module. So here what you are doing, right, you are trying to understand the requirements. Now the next requirement is video updates. Video updates is nothing but verify how many videos are available, verify whether all the videos are accessible, verify all the videos are playing without any interruptions. So all these things you need to verify as a tester. And then you are having a few more requirements, but we will be understanding these first three requirements for our learning purpose. If you understand like one or two requirements and working with other requirements will be of the same procedure and same way. You are having another requirement saying that you can contact your H2K team through online, and you are having the blogs. If you have any queries, you can post your queries in the app so that you will be getting the response from the team, and you can contact your H2K Infosys team. And one more requirement, final requirement, is landscape view. That means whatever you are testing, whatever you are working with this application should support landscape mode. Landscape, for the time being, landscape mode is nothing but the horizontal mode of your mobile. Say for example, if you are sending a message to your friends, what you will do, you will change the position of your mobile. That means you will tilt your mobile so that you can see a big screen, and then you will start typing your message. Agree with me? That is called landscape mode. Landscape mode is nothing but that horizontal mode, and then we have to make sure that your application is supporting your landscape mode. Let me show you what you mean by landscape mode. Yeah, I will show you that. This is your landscape mode. This is your landscape mode. That means, right, your screen size will change. Now the requirement says that if user wants to connect with that H2K team, he can use normal mode, which is nothing but portrait, and he can also use that landscape. Landscape is nothing but you are changing the position of your mobile, or you are tilting your mobile. Okay, so if customer is in portrait or landscape, it should work. Okay, clear? So these are all the requirements which we need to test, and then which we need to test for both your Android and iOS platforms. Clear? Fine, let's move further.